Aye, aye, Captain. All right, 44 Arena. Slavs. I'll have the timestamp in the description, apparently. 13 minutes of this. Maybe I'll cut out the start. I don't know. Thank you, someone else. There are actually a lot of Australians in the chat here. So if you guys are looking to play with Mist, by all means. It wouldn't be a game at Aoe2 if I just kick other people with 9,000 ping. Like, this wouldn't be the same. I've actually found that I play worse with no latency because I'll pull my villager back when I'm luring the boar before it even shoots the boar. Because I'm used to about like a 5-second delay. So, for those of you that may or may not know this, if you just skipped ahead or you just got here, this is a version of Arena that I made myself this morning right before the stream started, where I basically just took it, the exact same source code, and I swapped out most of the animals for random African Kingdoms ones. Today, llamas, if you play this map again later, sometimes goats. Perhaps I might even build upon it, and that way we just get everything, because I feel like I like the old maps a lot, I just wish that they had the new assets in them. One of the things that the devs did in order to make adding additional DLC a lot easier is they made it so you have like no chance of spawning like cows, for example, on Arena, because it's a non-DLC map. And that's unfortunate because I miss that a lot, and if there's enough community pressure for it, the devs might revert that change. It would be annoying, but they're willing to do it if there's enough community pressure, and I hope that you guys love goats as much as I do. Sorry if I'm missing some people's messages. Chat's moving a little bit quickly, and I'm trying my best to play the game while talking at the same time. I'm so sorry, Fletch. Oh, you leave for 1 minute, and RNGesus is a fickle god. He's a fickle god. That's why we have res rigged. Sorry, Fletch. I'll make it up to you. Gloopbot says the thing with the boar that I did so many times in Zero Empires tutorial. I had to send my vill back because I only shot the boar once, I was expecting lag. Yep. Yep. Of course, Gloopod is referring to Zach's Fancy Pants awesome and helpful interactive fast castle tutorial, which I think is a very good idea. I did a similar thing with my friends when I was teaching them a game many, many years ago. I would show them how to do strategies in like a scenario where it would give them like live instructions and help task their villagers. And Zach's version is like a million times better. Another cow says, how do we put pressure for cows? Leave a post on the forums. Leave a very polite post on Reddit where you'd be like, you know, Cision, I love cows. I'm a pro-cow person. I used to be depressed until I saw cows in Arena. If we're polite about it and casually remind the devs, they would do it. If not, because I understand it's a lot of work and resources to maintain that level of compatibility, dude, I'll just model the old maps. Or maybe someone will. I want to take this a step further and make it so instead of like 3 different sets of stuff, that there are like 4 different ones, maybe 5, that way we can see goats, cows, llamas, turkeys, sheep, everything. I want everything in here. I want bears, lions, crocodiles, you name it. Shape in the Shadow says, have you ever played Supreme Commander? No, but I watched my friend play it when I was much younger. Watch this, all good man, I'll just wait another month or two. Well, hopefully we play before then. Okie dokie. Yeah, feel free to post your message again in the chat if I missed it. Just wait like 5 minutes. No reason to spam. I'm not going anywhere. And as always, guys, thank you so much for all the support. Really appreciate all the people who take the time to leave a nice comment, as well as respond to some comments on my behalf. You're the real hero. Always wonderful to have you guys. My strategy this game will probably be something along the lines of a Scorpion Rush. I'd like to do that, but I am on the flank, so it might not be fantastic here. I think the Slavs' biggest change was like their farming rate got improved slightly. Zerook says, how do you think the depth of gameplay of Aoe2 holds up with other RTS and MOBAs? I'd say it's up there, very, very high. I think this game has tremendous strategic depth, and that's why I still play it after all these years. And the lag is real. I don't know what this woman is doing. I think she just forgot how to hunt. Is she okay? There we go. Excuse me, lady. Lady, are you still the pulse? Not sure if Rez told me to hunt the boar or grab a stake and just stand next to the boar. I like how everything in this game is actually stakes. Even the fancy pants bushes. Mothlum, thank you for the $20 donation. Much appreciated. It says, keep up the great work. Love the streams, Rez. You make all the work I put in worthwhile. Your support means a lot. Thank you. Thank you. Cool. Or underneath the TC. If I don't get to rush with scorpions because I'm in the pocket, I'll at least make a bunch of them. So this is, Visby, this is the standard arena map that we all know and love, but I replaced the bushes. These are not forage bushes, my friends. This is your $10 DLC here. These are fruit bushes. They're different. Functionally the same, but they're yellow and they contain lemons. And life is better with lemons. So I just I took the standard code and I just replaced all the assets with the African Kingdoms ones. Functionally, it's exactly the same. So if your map gen sucks, whoa! Scout buddy, calm down. That was weird. If your map gen sucks, it's actually not my fault. I claim no responsibility for this. I actually use the standard code. Just change the assets. Lydex is, do you think the Britons should get paladins with them being a Western civ? That might make them too strong. I'm not sure. I think the Britons aren't a top-tier civ. I don't know if it'd push them over the edge. It's something to consider. Maybe Bloodlines is fine to give them. Maybe. I have to experiment. I think they could use a little bit of something. Someone else says her name is Annie. It's who Michael Jackson was asking if she was okay. She was. Annie, are you okay? Thank you, Mothim. Dragon Fireburn says, Resident 22, what about dragons? Well, welcome to the stream, Dragon Fireburns. I am pro-dragon. I think dragons are the bee's knees. Speaking of dragons, check out this dragon tree. Did this just for you right before the stream. Now, hopefully I have enough energy to get through this game, as it's getting late. Streaming all day. I'm a little exhausted. My allergies are bad. But I'm going to put up with it. I'm going to build some farms. See if I can survive. Just one more game, Rez. You can do it. You guys like the moonwalk? That's one of my favorite features. When I got the honor, and I'm so happy that I got a chance to do this. The honor of beta testing African Kingdoms and giving my feedback to the devs. Like, they really do care. Like, Cision and the Forgotten Empire's team, by the way, who are not responsible for the bugs. They're the content side. They're responsible for all the balancing concepts. They care a lot. And when I got a chance to do the beta testing and bug testing, it was an honor. I told them, though, that I just don't think it's worth investing the resources fixing the fixing that bug where units moonwalk. If anything, that justified my purchase. I was happy to spend all the money I've spent in Aoe2. Because the moonwalking bug is great. It's something that Voobly doesn't have. And while Voobly has a number of amazing features, it doesn't have animated water or moonwalking scouts. So we have to dock a few points there. Lupot asks, what's better, a moonwalking scout or a moonwalking boar? I think the moonwalking scout. Redback says, get the devs to bring back the flying dogs. I think that they're still in the game. I could add them to this map if you want, though. I believe you can do that. They should still be in the game. Wood Diaper says, I know exactly one person in my life who has ever said the phrase, it's the bee's knees, pretty awesome. There are a lot of weird things that I say. I have a lot of strange habits. But that's how you know that I didn't get replaced with some sort of imposter ghost. Lupot says, Resonance, did you ever ask for a Resonance feature in the expansion like an Easter egg? No, I didn't. I thought that would be selfish. But if the devs ever get excess resources and they feel like doing something like that, I would love it. But, you know, I don't want to bother them with that. We have bigger fish to fry. Bigger fish to fry. I almost became Sean Connery for a minute. So, guys, what time does Sean Connery play Wimbledon? What time does he play Wimbledon? Distracted, so my delivery is bad, but I swear this joke is terrible. At tennis. And that's the story about how I met my ex-girlfriend. Good times. Bad jokes will go a long way, especially if you ever have a kid someday. It's a dad's responsibility to embarrass them at every given opportunity. 6 o'clock. Very, very close, Huskington. Very close. It's a tennis. Oh, thank you, Wishcraft, for the badumch. This castle time is positively mediocre. It's alright. But, not getting any awards for this one. It's okay. You know, while I'm advancing the next stage, I'm hungry. Let me grab a cracker. Sorry for muting my mic for a moment. Don't want you to hear my gross chewing sounds. It's okay, Phantom Max. The trick is, I got housed when I wasn't creating any villagers. Doesn't count. Welcome, Timmy's Oh Boy. Welcome to stream. Well, Mist, I'm in the pocket position, which means I'm surrounded by my teammates, so I'm not sure if a Scorpion Rush is viable, but... Is mass scorpions okay? I will scorpion rush at some point. A bunch of people have been asking me to do a scorpion rush because I have a Break the Meta episode where DauT goes for a scorpion rush, and a bunch of people want to see that in action because it's almost a real strategy. It's almost real. It's real in the other sense. Oh, it's real. Like, normally I don't snack on stream, but I'm just really hungry because the stream has been going on for so long. I'm also tired. Hello, Ash Ford, CBD. Lydiac says mass scorpions is always okay. Thank you, Lydiac. Appreciate it. Marked of Cake says, why are they called scorpions? I'm actually not sure. Perhaps a history major could inform me. I have so much food! They've created a monster. The devs have created a monster. The new Slavs are so pee. What am I gonna do with all these steaks? Or corn? Never get used to the fact it's corn in HD. So much untapped power. Stand aside, puny mortals, for I am Slavs. Hear me roar. Hello to Doobdap, good to see ya. Yeah, there are a lot of people here. Thanks to Zero Empires, who hosted my stream at the end. After his birthday stream, Doobadap, he is now officially 3 billion years old. Grandfather Zach. Seems like just yesterday I subbed to his channel. Actually, today is my 19-month anniversary of being subbed to Zero Empires. Very happy about that. It's a special day. Everybody can shed a manly tear. Support your local Zero Empires every day! And then drink your Ovaltine. Oh. That would be bad. Station thy scout in front of your base to prevent that. That way you can see it coming. React accordingly. Zoxer, when I upload this to YouTube, I'll have all the mods in the video description. Maybe one of my own mods could link a few. I have all the mods listed in the video description of everything, every video I have on my channel. And it's also in the About section of my YouTube channel, I think. Oh, Eschato! Eschafin. Thank you for asking again, I appreciate your patience, as I realize I think I missed that question earlier. I don't tell people where I go to school usually, and the off chance that for some reason someone actually happens to go to the same school that I do. Because when I'm at school, I'm generally just like every other college student, and where the hell are my stone mines? There we go. And then I'm basically just groggy, drinking my coffee, just there for the lecture, so I didn't want anybody to, you know, come up and they'd be like, hey, Resin, big fan. I don't think that would ever happen, but maybe. And then I'd be like, I'm tired, man. I think that'd be really lame. So I'll say California. Go to a community college in California. Next year I'd like to transfer, though. Next year I move out. And with the support of you guys, I might actually be able to barely pay the rent. Which is amazing. It's like the dream. A lot of people think that, like, streaming is the dream, and it's, like, the best job ever. And I would say that it's, like, the most fun job ever, but holy shit, it's a lot of work. But it's the type of work that I really enjoy, and that's what counts. So, looking forward to that. It'll be fun. Brummy Snake says, Rez, what are you studying at college? Poli-sci, political science. Though I might change my major at some point. You brute! Back off, you ruffian! The Black Wind says, what was your grade in Zach's Fast Castle scenario? I haven't done it yet. I've been so busy. I've had like an hour of free time every day, trying desperately to get my transfer applications done. And then survive all my other projects. Thank you to Dubidat for the resub. I really appreciate it. Always nice to have you. Someone else says, oh yes, all college students are constantly wondering where their stone mines are. Yeah, it's a reoccurring problem in this economy. What the fuck? This gate is useless! My grandfather's base has no weak lumber camps, Kaiba. Oh shit, that's the worst place to put a TC. There's the end of the edge of the maps there. And there's so much delay that I actually lost like 5 stone. This game is bad. We're gonna play competitive tic-tac-toe. At least there's no lag in tic-tac-toe. Kidding, of course. Alright. Not bad. Make some scorpions or something to deal with this. Looks like Sloppy J's score is not so great, so perhaps he's done more damage to himself than he has to TK with that. Smus says, Resonance, would you like to see more unique buildings at the Portuguese Feitoria in future expansions? Yes, provided they're not a Feitoria. While I like the Feitoria a lot, and I feel like it plays to my strengths as a player, I think it's incredibly hard to balance. And I think a building like that should either be for everybody or for nobody. And based off the values, it's either going to be completely useless or absolutely busted. I think it kind of is tricky to balance for things like 1v1s, 500 pop games, lower skilled games, etc. I like it, though. I would like to see more unique buildings, but maybe something a little bit more balanceable, I guess. I like the idea of the Feitoria, I just fear that conceptually it's tricky. I think, though, that they actually have the Feitoria in a very good spot, and I'd be wary of changing it. Maybe the stone generation is just a teeny bit too high, and maybe the food and wood's a little bit too low, but I think they're golden. And, yeah, here's the Seed Workshop hype for you. I'm actually doing it. Crapty cruds. Gonna get housed here briefly, but that's okay. It's okay. It's just time for a strategic town watch, of course. You never know when you're gonna need town watch. Oh, jeez. I could really go for a wheelbarrow right now. Now, I know what you're thinking. I'm unhoused. I don't need to do any of these things. I need those techs anyway, so it's just a good reminder. Sorry if I'm missing some people's questions. I'm trying my best to play right now, and we're getting to that point in the game where it requires a little bit more of my attention, so. You're going to ask again in a couple minutes, but I gotta move all these buttons. I gotta press these buttons and move all these units. Laddie, I guess if I can play some scenarios in streams when I get the chance. Maybe, but ooh, lots of military buildings there. Generally, I find that there's just not enough for me to talk about when I'm playing a scenario, and that people just don't enjoy them as much. So, I don't know if it's worth my time. I have a limited amount of free time, so generally try to spend it doing things that I know people really enjoy. I mean, I still do things that are non-AoE2, though, which I've covered in the update video. But, like, I don't know. So the answer is VOC. Depends on the scenario. Depends on the demand. I'm open to it. I'm open to all sorts of ideas and feedback. Okay, so, no matter what I do, I probably want this thing at some point. Do I need blacksmith upgrades if I'm massing scorpions? Resonance asking the deep existential questions. Well, you know, I'm actually probably going to need something in the front of these, so unfortunately, I probably have to make some pikes at the front. I said mass scorpions. Well, it's a fun strategy that there is some legit strategic merit to it, otherwise I wouldn't do it. No matter what I do in my games, I want everybody to know that I am always trying my best to win. Even if I'm experimenting, there's always a method to my madness. When I lose, it doesn't mean I wasn't trying. And of course, also if I show mercy to new players, it also doesn't mean I'm not trying to win. Usually I just direct my aggression towards another player instead, in the interest of fairness. But I don't really need to explain all that. I missed a donation? What? Thank you, Jagger Style, for the donation. And thank you, Flatch and someone else, for reminding me. Much appreciated. So, get sent me $1. He says, I hate birds. What kind of birds do you hate and why? What is your deep history with the birds? A bird killed my father when I was very young. I don't talk about this story very often, guys, but when I was 3 years old, a pigeon flew up to my window and he picked up my dad and brought him to the moon, and I haven't seen him since. It keeps me up at night wondering if my dad is going to be okay on the moon. Up there with the Martian pigeons. Oh, man. Those are scary. Give me that arson. This tech is disgusting. Extra 2 bonus damage for its buildings. I want some of this. This is the earliest I've ever researched heavy scorpions. And I've had, like, what, 2,200 hours in HD alone? And then I have probably several thousand in the old classic CD version. This is the earliest I've ever got heavy scorpion. Let's test out this bad boy on this here lion. In the jungle, the mighty jungle. This lion doesn't even respond. I thought that wolves, lions, and stuff should respond to you, to that. Is that a bug? Is the scorpion too powerful? The lion just can't even process it? He's like, That's weird. Played a lot of games at Aoe, but I have never once got heavy scorpion this soon. Now, I'm building this castle this far back because I don't want to get raided, and this should keep my base safe. So, I want to discourage any future raiding should my opponents get any fancy ideas. I have way too many gold miners for what I'm doing, and probably not enough lumberjacks. Probably not enough farmers either, honestly. Well, I'll need to send backup over here. You know, I'm not gonna mess with that lion. I'm gonna protect the wildlife. Explod says I was a soldier once before a bird took out my knee. Happens to the best of us, dude. Condrictus asks, what's your favorite musical track for AoE? I don't know the names of all them, because Stephen Rippey, who's an amazingly talented composer, names them weird things. That's just what he does. So I actually don't know the names of all the songs. Taser is one of them that I know that I like. So we'll say Taser is certainly one of them. Now the weakness with this army comp, even though it's actually reasonably well balanced and the units actually do cover each other's weaknesses somewhat well, I don't actually have an answer to buildings yet, so arson is a step, but it's not exactly what the doctor ordered. Me want this. Oh, that's a lot of units. Crud. Cruddy cruds. Cruddy McCrudderson. That is not okay. Oh, I'm gonna need more unit production facilities. Those are not my friends. Hendrick, this is hum a few bars. That'll take way too much of my attention while I'm playing. I'm sorry. I'd be happy to do that between games or something. Hopefully TK is doing okay here, because, like, what I like is that, you know, while TK is getting heavily, heavily pressured, note that TK's score is still really high, because TK is a smart cookie. He went to college, just like Plankton. And he knows that in the face of adversity, when you're being attacked like such, the idea is that you don't neglect your economy. So, like, instead of panicking and just not building TCs, like, this man's got 4 town centers. He's still making villagers the entire time. And that's important because he's actually able to outboom Red, and while, you know, he made cuts to his military, while TK did, in order to do this, if he is able to hold the line, it's a gamble, and he was, then he wins, because his economy is so big that, you know, Red's kind of all in here. He's just going to fall apart. I blow your ears, says Rez, if you're on arena with the full walls in front of your base, what's the point of putting a castle further behind that? Don't you think it'd be GG long before your walls could breach? That's a good point. There are games, though, that I've played, believe it or not, where it wasn't GG when my walls got breached. Sometimes my walls will get opened up by things like trade carts, so sometimes it happens. Perhaps this castle is ambitious, but it's happened before, where the game actually didn't end when I got breached. It's happened enough that I think it's worthwhile, and I don't think that there's necessarily any benefit to building it closer. This is actually pretty good. By the power of Grayskull, I have the power! Not bad. Do you, Slavs? Does the Slav Master Race get Siege Rams? Because I think they'd be real strong. This is pretty good. Hello, Gilgwoth! He says, are you doing Siege and Trash? Woo! Indeed. I'm doing my best impression of the Celts. Celts cosplay. I think it's pretty convincing. Hazardclash says, Arvid says hi. Hello, Arvid. Welcome to the stream. Do you like scorpions, Arvid? Because I like scorpions a lot. Going for mass scorpions, it's not just Siege and Trash. It's much better than Siege and Trash. It's Siege and Trash with scorpions. Adam the Rabbit, that is cheating. Cheating. Everyone knows you're not allowed to make counter units like kennels. I will send assistance to TK, who appears to be getting ganged up on slightly. Those Albertiers should take care of that without too many issues. I would like to make some boyars as well at some point, but that's awfully taxing on my food. Well, it's actually not that expensive. The secret to success, my friends, is to make sure you have lots of villagers, at least 100. Basically every online game is 200 or more population, so you'll always want at least half the max pop. So consider 100 the minimum, try and get there ASAP. And no matter what you're doing, whether you're touching yourself at night, you're making knights, going for archer rush, whatever, you know, just make sure that you're making villagers or researching something with your town center. It should always be doing something. No matter what you're doing. Do I get siege rams? God, this civ is great. Bless you, Cision. You magnificent, magnificent bastard. Oh, there's the army. Mr. Plutonium! Professor Plutonium, Utonium, it's time. Create the Powerpuff Girls and send those military units in. Mr. Plutonium, it is time to unleash hell. Bring your forces forward so that we may conquer our enemies. I think it's always important to add a little bit of flavor. Imagine how much more fun games like Dota would be if everybody on your team was a filthy role player. Be so much more fun. If people were telling you to go fuck yourself in Russian in character, I think that would be much. I think it'd be great. I think everybody should just have a little bit more fun when they're playing online. I'd love to add a little bit of flavor to the trash talk and whatnot. Mr. Plutonium, I meant that you actually would go this direction, but good news is TK's a strong, independent Persian player who doesn't need any pocket. Sickmo TV says, instructions unclear. I'm touching my bills and producing the underwear. Ah, that's a problem. Might want to work on that build order. I don't know if that's very good. That's a lot of idols. Sorry, Plutonium. This is a government mine, and I'm going to have to... You're under arrest. I'm going to have to seize those assets. Good old Age of Empires 2 lag edition. But I think it's worth it. For all the content. I stopped making scorpions. Whoops. I lost track of my... Lost track of my dreams. Forgot what I stood for a minute. Sniper Jelly says, fuck magic. Yeah, exactly! If you play anti-mage, you should be talking about all those... Oh, those heathens and how much you hate magic. Wait, why am I building a gold mine over there when I have a gold mine right here? Well, I mentioned this earlier, but not only is Zach getting old, so am I. Eyesight's not so good anymore. Yes, Goldmine, is that you? Come closer, I'm not so sure anymore. Yes, Yugi, that's definitely a heart attack. So, snag some of these upgrades. I think this is also one of the longest times I've waited to get Onager, but I honestly don't need it, so I think it's okay. Yeah, generally ask permission to post links, guys. I don't know what my policy is supposed to be on links. I'm a terrible poli-sci major because I have no strong feelings on most things. So feel free to give me your feedback on my link policy and whatnot. Like, I'm open to ideas. What I can say is that I'm strictly anti-spam bot, so if you're a spam bot, just know that we don't serve your kind here. I just don't want people coming into my chat and just, like, spamming, like, hey man, do you guys know what a good Aoe2 channel is? Yeah. Resonance 22 TM, you should... I don't want people doing that for just whatever, plugging all their stuff. I don't want spam bots coming in here sending me to the hot local Latino singles. We don't need any of that. It's just a virus anyway. CSL Fix, thank you for tuning in. Drictus asks, what hotkeys do you use? Mostly the control numbers. I use most of the ones to place a military building and build the military buildings. I use H plus C to make villagers. It's much easier for me to list ones I don't use. Wow, well, the enemy team is actually staging a comeback. What the hell? Wait, where'd the love go? And I don't really use the ones to jump to military buildings. I actually just hotkey them. That's just force of habits. Nothing my way is necessarily bad, but it's different for sure. Probably marginally more efficient to use the hotkeys to jump between types of military buildings. But I do this to easily change my gather points. When did games start getting really hard? What the hell? It seems like just last week we were winning. Memory's not so good anymore. Game got real difficult real fast. Unbelievable. Crud. Too many ranged units. I need to regroup. I'm rallying all my units and they're not messing up properly. I use the classic hotkeys, Timmy. Alright, I'm gonna have to regroup my stuff. Horbic says, why does the slob buildings look like crap? They look fine. I don't know if there's a mod for it, though. But to each his own, you know? They definitely look different. Maybe it's just that I'm, like, biased and that I'm just so happy that this game has any degree of support or community at all after so long. Aoe2 has always been my favorite game. You know, I might see other games from time to time, but I always come crawling back to Aoe2 being like, hey baby, I can change. Okay, that's a lot of hand cannoneers. I think it's disgusting that my opponents are using unit counters against me. They're learning. I'm self-aware. Alright, well, I'm actually having difficulty getting pop-capped. And one of the things that I always struggle with as a player is booming all the way, getting my economy as big as it needs to on maps where there's just not enough space to build. When I feel claustrophobic, I feel like I underdo my villagers just because there's like not enough space to put the farms, which is bad. Because I actually still need more vills. If I'm running out of money and I'm not able to hit the pop cap, that means something is wrong. I think my army comp is still fine though. Yeah, because the halberdiers cover all the cavalry that they have, and my scorpion should deal with all of the hand cannoneers. Scorpion's very strong as the hand cannoneers, they have very low pierce armor. Erides says, classic hotkeys mean the hand cramping ones? Yes. I also played Dota with legacy hotkeys back in the day. Well, because I'm a masochist, and back then, we didn't have anything better. Okay. Coming, buddy. Oh, check out the scorpion value! Holy shit! That's so strong! You fools! You puny mortals! You don't stand a chance. I'm Nice try. Wow, this is great. If someone does this to you, mass scorpions are giving you problems. The secret to success is just, like, an onager or, like, a bombard cannon will deal with scorpions incredibly easily. Pisces asks, why not transition to trade? Generally, I think that a lot of players transition to trade too early, and that if there are gold mines, then you should do it. The trick is transitioning just as you have gold mines left, but they're running low, so you have enough gold to spend on trade carts, because for some reason in this game, you have to invest gold in the trade carts. Trade carts are already incredibly inefficient, very expensive, very slow to create, compared to something like just mining. So I find it funny that they actually cost gold. That's why I like Age of Mythology system, where they don't cost gold, and you can trade with your own markets. I digress. I should start transitioning into it now. I generally wait a lot longer when I play Arena, because trading on this map is the worst. It's so annoying. Very difficult to establish a good safe trade line here, compared to something like Black Forest. Well, Catharsis appears to be quite the strong player. However, he did not bank on my heavy scorpions. For that, he will pay the ultimate price. Explod says, imagine making your own hero. They can come into each match from the start. That'd be interesting. I wonder if having hero units in Aoe2 is something that would destroy the game and make it too different, or if it's something that could actually work. I feel like it kind of worked in the Aoe2 DS version, but beyond that, I don't know. That's one of the more interesting parts about Empires Apart for me, is that they're going to have like heroes and stuff, I think. I think they said that. I might be horribly wrong. And I wonder if that's a good or bad idea. We'll have to see. I look forward to playing Empires Apart when it is further along development. Same thing with Prismata and whatnot. You can expect a lot more extra content, AoE2 stuff and non-AoE2 stuff, as soon as I'm on winter break. Just keep in mind that anything they do that's not AoE is just extra content. And your support is appreciated. Explain all this in the update video, but it's very important for the longevity of the channel and for content creators' own sanity that they explore, have fun. Why are we talking about we're talking about the DS version of AoE2? Yeah, I used to play that a lot because sometimes it's just not practical to play Age of Empires 2, like, for example, on a road trip. It can be difficult to do that, because then you have to play on a ThinkPad, or trackpad or something, like a laptop. Thank you, Mangadide, for the resub, much appreciated. So that's where the DS version comes in. I actually have a video on it, which you guys feel free to check out if you are interested at all. I actually thought the DS version was quite good. If you like Advance Wars, you'll probably enjoy it a lot. Shit! Ah! Where is the love going? Alright, well, love's going over here, I guess. Good lord. This game is very difficult. The DS version is turn-based. Again, I have a video of that on my channel if you're curious what it looks like in practice. I thought it was pretty good. If I was Crip, I would say. It's pretty good. It's basically Advance Wars. Doesn't suck, can confirm. I might do another video on it eventually, because I don't think I showed off that much of the late game combat in units. I like Advance Wars a lot, so it's something that I enjoyed. If you hold shift, you can actually queue up 5 units at a time. I do it individually, rather than just selecting all the military buildings, and then pressing it, because it doesn't always distribute them evenly. It's important that I don't overboom, so I don't want to be floating like a billion of each resource. It's a careful balance between not overbooming and then also making sure that you have sufficient resources to sustain production. If you overboom, though, you can always just delete villagers, sell resources at the market, or just attribute it to your teammates. You got options. Indeed, I am sub to Crip. The Crip. Believe it or not, I am also a Twitch user and YouTube user in my spare time. Gotta keep up on the latest Twitch memes. Latest and greatest. That's how I model my channel. Basically after things that mean a lot to me as a viewer, as a fan. I got the opportunity when I went to BlizzCon this year to actually meet Day 9, which was amazing, and he was even cooler in person than I expected, and I already think he's the greatest thing since sliced bread. I look up to him, and I want to provide that experience for you guys. Like, when you come here, you should feel loved, and even though I can't respond to everyone's YouTube comments, just know that I read them, and that I care. Lubot says, I found it distributes them pretty evenly now, compared to when HD first came out. That's a good sign, so maybe I don't need to go the extra mile anymore when it comes to queuing up my units. But when it comes to interacting with people, I always try to go the extra mile. This game is hard and long. Might need to split into two parts, but if I do that, you can always just find the second part in the video description. Got no gold. Crud. Okay, so I think I'm doing pretty well this game, but maybe not well enough. I will say this, the scorpions are getting insane value, and I look forward to the next time I get to use them. At some point I would like to... Does this affect scorpions? I don't think it does. I still should have added earlier anyway. Not that any of my units benefit from it, but it's a good technology anyway. You never know if I decide to transition to something else. The scorpions are strong. I'll do a scorpion rush at some point, but even just throwing in scorpions can be great. I know I'm not the Chinese, but just imagine what I could do if I was the Chinese. This, of course, is hard countered by bombarded cannons and onagers, so if my opponents start making them, I probably have to transition to that. I guess the point. Hal Reno, hello! He says, did you know what else is hard and long? No, tell me, Hal. Please inform me. Twitch Chud, do you know what he's talking about? Alright, oh god, that was gonna be a sick scorpion shot. Just imagining a line straight down there. Hey, Pete. Yeah, squinty-eyed with the Craigasm. Twitch emotes are just such a wonderful idea. I ended up getting into YouTube because, like, for the longest time, I would just sit and just watch my brother do stuff. My brother has always been a huge role model in my life and someone that I always look up to. Wonderful guy. As a kid, I would just watch him do stuff. Play games. Like, one of my favorite things to do was not necessarily to play games, but to watch my brother play games. And one time he was showing me YouTube, like when it just came out. And I didn't have an internet connection because I was too young. My parents wanted to shield me from, obviously the Twitch chat, which didn't exist back then, I guess. Maybe they were trying to shield me from all the hot local Latino singles online. I didn't have internet back then. And when he was explaining to me how YouTube worked, I was like fascinated. It like blew my mind you could have something where you just upload videos of cats and thousands, millions of people, billions of people will watch videos of cats in glorious 240p master race with pixels the size of dinner plates. That blew my mind. And I wanted to get into it, like, ever since I was a very young. I was always fascinated with YouTube. And Twitch, the same. I was like, really? You're telling me that like 20,000, memers can get together in one chat room and they just spam? Yeah, it's a beautiful thing. I try to use Twitch, obviously, for other things, though, and then rather just to post memes, I think we can also be friends. To build a wonderful, welcoming, friendly community that hopefully makes up for all the times that someone told you to go fuck yourself when you were playing whatever online game you were playing. Try to make up for that. Assassin says he's got two guys on him. Which is a normal problem for Assassin, wink wink. I'm kidding. Crap, Catharsis, he figured it out. Not only that, he's Spanish, so he is, Oh, I know, I'm thinking of Portuguese that has the super accurate sniper, bombard cannons. Ah, my trade cards. Okay, there's the market. No!